Welcome to Angie's Creative Studio. I'm Angie. Today, as promised, is we did the tracing or drawing of a picture the other day. And we are going to do the colored, and I'm using colored pencils. I'm using just a cheapo sketchbook from Walmart. I am using Prism Corners. I'm using light Sierra blue, denim blue, deoxide purple hue. I'm using the colorless blender, dark brown, 10% coral gray, black, 90 coral gray, yellow ochre, and burnt henna PC 1031. That's the colored pencils I'm using for this. I've done a few to see if I can still do this. I'm going to start out with the light Sierra blue, the PC 904. And I'm going to start on the saucer. And I'm just going around. And I've got puppies. They 6 weeks old. As of yesterday. As of Sunday. And then I'm just going to go in just lightly and just kind of, and I'm using that, I've got, well, my pinch don't have really any pressure on it. Playing, we got one male for sale. The female is sold. She's going to a lady, I think, in the Rock. Now I'm going in with the denim blue. I'm just doing. But now I've got a more of a pressure. I'm doing more of a detail. And turn your paper. Don't be afraid to turn your paper. I mean, I'm going to have my paper every certain way to get what I need. I can tell you that right now. And I'm just using this pompon, this deoxide pompon hue as a just kind of defined as a shadow. And that's all I'm wanting. And I'm going back with the denim and just kind of blending it in as much as possible. Okay, now I'm going in with the denim and I'm going to make my line of my cup. And I'm just going I am trying to stay in frame, but I'm having issues. Now you can use whatever colored pencils you have. You don't have to have these. This is the set of 150. I caught them on a pretty darn good deal off of Amazon a couple weeks, a month or so ago, and I fell in love with them. Well, my first set was a 36 piece, and you can do it with those if that's all you have. You can use, I mean, you don't have to have the blue and the pompon. I mean, you can do your coffee cup and saucer any color you want. That's just what I'm using. If that makes sense to anybody besides me. And then I'm just going in with the light blue and blending the coffee cup as much as possible. And now I'm going in with the cordless blender. I'm not happy right here. Means I'm fixing the overall kit. As usual, I'm not happy with it. Thank you. Okay, I'm going to take a erase one because I'm just not liking this. Let's do here as much as I should. And erase ones, believe it or not, is your best friend with colored pencils. Because they can lighten it up where you can't any other way. Okay. Must just gonna have to be. Now I'm taking the 10% cool gray and I'm going around the rim of the cup. And this is not gonna give it a good tint, but it will give it a little bit of a tint. And you probably can't see it on camera as well as I can with my eyes. I mean, without it being on camera. And the reason why I got the glove on is because I ain't got the hang of not being on my work at all times. And I don't want the oils in my hands to rub off. And now I'm going around the circle with the same cool 10% gray. And like I said, this is the 150 set that I'm using. But you can use Crayolas, whatever you have. Now I'm going in with the 90% gray. I am not good with coffee cups yet. So y'all may want to watch somebody else do a coffee cup. I am learning. And I'm just taking y'all on my adventures. Now I'm going to go ahead and do my shadows in the 90% gray. And I'm just going and see how I'm just getting light on. Okay, now I'm going in with the dark brown and I'm coloring in my coffee. I'm Now I'm using the black. Thank you. Okay. Now, I'm just making this look like black coffee. I mean, you can make it creamy, whatever you want it. I don't drink coffee, so I used to. I love my coffee. It just don't love me, and I cannot stand decaf, so. I'm just going to blend this in, kind of. I'm just going to blend this out a little. I love these blendable pencils. Okay, now I'm going to take my yellow ochre and I'm going to sharpen it. So, use the sharpener. And I'm just going in, and I'm just going as lightly as age to the oven. And like I said, this is just a 8.5 by 5.5. Page I'm doing. I don't usually do. I mean, I can do big ones. I don't normally, mostly for camera, but, and I'm going over my shadows to kind of just blend them on in with the tabletop. Now I'm taking this 1031 PC Hannah, and I'm just going to go over it just as lightly as I did with the yellow ochre, just kind of giving it a red tint. And this is called layering your colored pencils. And now I'm going in with the dark brown. And I'm just going to give it to, I'm not going over the whole thing. I'm just going over sections of it just to make it look more like I want it. And you see that I've made it darker in spots than ever. Okay, that's it. I'm going to sign it. I'm just going to sign it with a regular pencil. And I sign it, and then I date it of the day I do it, that I finish. And I just write Angie on my on my stuff. I don't ever put a last name on it. I don't know why, but
I don't.
You'd think I would, but I don't. And there we have it. I've tore the paper. I should have heated the gannet, but it's been on for a couple days. I hope y'all enjoy this tutorial. If you like this type of stuff, subscribe below. I will catch y'all later. Have a blessed day. Bye.